Asthma has no cure. Current treatments in allergic airway disease primarily focus on resolving the symptoms. While spending time in the high-risk asthma clinic at the Riley Hospital for Children, I observed that many patients had a more intermittent disease course.
With every breath we take, we breathe in allergens, which can cause symptoms such as wheezing, cough, and in severe cases, asthma exacerbations and hospitalization. These symptoms occur secondary to inflammation and mucus production in the bronchioles. Once exposed to the allergen, antigen-presenting cells can activate CD4-positive T cells to secrete cytokines, starting inflammatory cascades.
Here we hypothesize that interleukin-9 or IL-9, which is one of the cytokines produced by CD4 T cells, is also involved in allergic memory responses.
In our study, we observed a unique population of CD4 T cells that produce IL-9 along with IL-5 and IL-13. These cells express tissue-resident memory markers. Additionally, these cells also express ST2, which is an IL-33 receptor, and demonstrated amplified IL-9 production in the presence of IL-33 in an allergen-specific manner. Blockade of IL-9 led to a decrease in expression of several genes associated with mucus production in the epithelial cells. It led to a decrease in CD4 T cell, B cells, and also altered expression of activation markers on macrophages and innate lymphoid type 2 cells.
Asthma exists in multiple forms, and seasonal or intermittent asthma can be very different from asthma that results from chronic exposure to allergens. What our work demonstrates is that targeting IL-9 may be more beneficial in specific subsets of asthma. This work also defines a population of memory cells that mediates allergic recall responses, and further study of this function of this subset in mice and patients may lead to new targets for treatment of disease.